Please see the link in the description to download a worksheet for this video. If you've not already done so, we suggest that you watch the video on 3D shapes before watching this video. It's very common on 5th grade state math exams for us to be asked what 3D shape a net makes. In this video, we'll discuss what a net is, why we use them, that one three-dimensional shape may have many nets, the steps to identify a net, and common net examples. Although we use the word net to refer to other objects in everyday life, in math, we use the word net to refer to a three-dimensional shape that we've cut along some of its edges, unfolded, and is now flat. A common reason why we learn about nets is because it helps us see all the faces of a three-dimensional shape. Later in fifth grade math, we use nets when trying to calculate the surface area of a three-dimensional object. One three-dimensional shape may have many nets. We can cut a three-dimensional shape in many different ways. For example, here's a square prism, commonly called a cube, that we've cut up in two different ways. By cutting it along different edges, we get a different net. That tells us that each three-dimensional shape may have several possible nets. A typical test question on nets will show us a net, then ask us to identify the 3D shape that it can make. Here's a method that you may find helpful for fifth grade math. We do two jobs. Job one is to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. Job two is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. There are three categories for 3D shapes that nets can make. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. Let's look at each category in more detail. The disc category is made of two shapes, cones and cylinders. Both of these 3D shapes have a disc. A disc is like a circle that has its center filled in. A cone has one disc, whereas a cylinder has two discs. Having a disc is a unique feature of 3D shapes in the disc category compared with other 3D shapes. The next category is pyramids. These are the pyramids we learn about in elementary school. Please note that all of these pyramids are made of more than two triangular faces. Having more than two triangular faces is a feature that's unique to the pyramid category. The next category is prisms. This category is made up of nets that have no discs, and they have two or fewer triangles. Let's look at a few examples. This is a triangular prism. Please note that it does have two triangles, but only two triangles, whereas a pyramid has more than two triangles, and it has no discs. Here's a square prism, of which the most famous example is a cube. There are no faces that are made of discs or triangles. Here's a rectangular prism. It has no faces that are made of discs or triangles. Here's a pentagonal prism. It has no faces that are made of discs or triangles. Here's a hexagonal prism. It has no faces that are made of discs or triangles. To summarize, the unique feature of the 3D shapes in the disc category is that they have one or more discs. The unique feature of the 3D shapes in the pyramid category is that they have more than two triangular faces. The unique feature of the 3D shapes in the prism category is that they have no discs, and they also have two or fewer triangular faces. Let's return to job one. We can do job one by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. If the answer is no, then go to question two. Are there more than two triangles? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is a pyramid. If the answer is no, then the 3D shape is a prism. Now we're ready for job two. Job two is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. We'll demonstrate how to do these jobs by using some common nets. What 3D shape does this net make? To solve this net, we start by doing job one. We need to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. We do job one by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. In this case, there is a disc. So we know this net is in the disc category, which contains cones and cylinders. Next, we go to job two, which is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. The base is this disc, and there is only one disc. When we put this net together, it makes a cone. Please note that the disc is on the curved side of the other piece of paper. Here's another example. What 3D shape does this net make? To solve this net, we start by doing job one. We need to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. We do job one by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. If the answer is no, then go to question 2. In this case, the answer is no. Question 2 asks, are there more than two triangles? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is a pyramid. We counted 4 triangles, which is a number greater than 2. So this net makes a pyramid. Next, we go to job 2, which is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. For pyramids, other than a triangular pyramid, the base is the one shape that is not a triangle. In this case, we find a square, so it's the base. This is a net for a square pyramid. When we put the net together, we get a square pyramid. Here's another example. What 3D shape does this net make? To solve this net, we start by doing job 1. We need to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. We do job 1 by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. If the answer is no, then go to question 2. In this case, the answer is no. Question 2 asks, are there more than two triangles? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is a pyramid. If the answer is no, then the 3D shape is a prism. We count up two triangles, which is a number equal to 2. It's not a number greater than 2, so this net goes with a prism. Next, we go to job 2, which is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. With the exception of cubes, in which all the faces are the same, for prisms the bases are the two faces, which are different than the other faces. In this case, we find two identical triangles. So, this net folds into a triangular prism. Here's another example. What 3D shape does this net make? To solve this net, we start by doing job 1. We need to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. We do job 1 by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. In this case, there is a disc. So we know this net is in the disc category, which contains cones and cylinders. Next, we go to job 2, which is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. The bases are the discs. When we put this net together, it makes a cylinder. Please note that the discs are on opposite sides of the rectangle. Here's another example. What 3D shape does this net make? To solve this net, we start by doing job 1. We need to put the net into one of three categories of 3D shapes. The categories are discs, pyramids, and prisms. We do job 1 by answering these questions. Is there a disc? If the answer is yes, then the 3D shape is in the disc category. If the answer is no, then go to question 2. In this case, there are no discs, so we go to question 2. Question 2 asks, are there more than two triangles? If the answer is no, then the 3D shape is a prism. In this case, the answer is no, so that tells us this is a prism. Next, we go to job 2, which is to identify the specific net by finding the base or bases. For a prism, the bases are the two faces that are identical to each other, but otherwise are different than all the other faces, unless the net is a cube, in which case all of the faces are identical. In this case, the two faces that are identical to each other, but different than all the other faces, are these pentagons. When we fold this net up, we get a pentagonal prism. We've made free access videos showing many examples of how to fold nets that are common in 5th grade. We'd encourage you to look at these. We put some links to these videos in the description. Thanks for your attention.